Thank you so much. All right. Good morning, everyone. Your assignment, your homework is done, right? Not yet. Okay, now we already done solving quadratic equation by factorization in quadratic formula. Now, let's move on how to apply for quadratic equation for step of problem solving. So, real life situation. So, we apply in real life situation. So, I have here a 4-step to apply or to solve quadratic equation by this idea. So, this is idea. Everyone say idea. Idea, I is for identify the problem. So, you need to identify the problem. And then, D represents as develop a solution. So, D, develop the solution. And E, evaluate, or you need to see the solution. And then, assess your answer. In assess your answer, you need to double check your answer. Now, let us apply this 4-step in problem solving. For example, so for this example, 2 consecutive positive odd numbers are such that the sum of their squares is 130. Find that 2 number. So, the problem is find the 2 numbers that positive add number and the sum of their squares is 130. So that is the problem. Okay? We need to get the 2 number that if the sum of the squares is 130. Now, the first step is we need to develop a solution. In developing solution, let X for the smaller number. Okay. And then, next is the second number. The next number is X plus 2. Because we need to get the positive add number. Okay? Now, in last equation is the sum of the squares is 130. So, we need to represent that. So, we have X squared plus X plus 2, which is the next number, should be equal to 130. Okay? So, this is the equation for this problem. Okay? So, the smaller number is X. We need to get the square also. And then X plus 2 square also. Okay? Is equal to 130. Now, we evaluate the solution. So, evaluate the solution. Remember in factoring, in the past lesson, right? So, we have X squared. And then this one, we need to expand it. So, we have X squared. This one plus 4X. And then plus 4. Is equal to, the constant number, remember, is equal to 130. Okay? We need to expand it. Now, process the formula. So, we have X squared plus X squared. We have 2X squared plus x. For this one, this is a constant. So, you need to transfer it to become negative 4. So, positive, it will become negative 4. Now, we have 126. Okay? Next step is we need to change that into standard form. Remember, what is the formula in getting the standard form for the quadratic equation? We have ax plus bx and then c is equal to 0. Okay? So, we need to do that. So, we have 2x squared plus 4x. And then this one, transfer, it will become negative 126 is equal to 0. So, this time, we are not yet done because we process the elimination. Eliminate by using common factor. To eliminate, what is the common factor for this equation? Common factor. The common factor is 2. So, we have x squared plus 2x and then minus 126 divided by 2 is 63 is equal to 0. Okay? Now, get the factor. Okay? So, what is the factor for x squared plus 2x minus 63? What is the factor of 63? And if we add, the answer is 2. The answer is 9 and 7. So, if we multiply 9 and 7, so, positive 9 and negative 7. Okay? So, 9 times 7 is equal to negative 63. If we add that one, 9, positive 9 plus negative 7, subtraction, so the result is 2. Positive 2. Okay? So, after that, we need to process it. So, the first x is negative 9. The second x is positive 7. So, in this problem, we don't need to use a negative. So, the first x is, the first number is 7. How about in the next number? So, based on the develop the solution, the next number is this one. X plus 2, right? So, we need to substitute x plus 2. So, in this case, we have value of x, which is 7. 7 plus 2 is equal to 9. So, the another number is 9. And that's it. Okay? So, we have the consecutive positive add number is 7 and 9. To double check, to assess your answer, they said sum of their squares is 130. So we have first number is 7 plus 9 is equal to 130. So 7 times 7 is 49 plus 81, 130. So 130 is equal to 130. So our answer is correct. Okay? Understand? Do you understand on getting the two numbers? Huh? All right, copy on your notebook in 2 minutes only. 2 minutes. That is the example on getting the two consecutive positive and numbers.
Ah, nalian do na ha. Jod, hai lao ha lai two consecutive positive odd number. ให้หาจำนวน odd number คู่หรือคี่จำนวนคี่สองจำนวนที่อยู่ติดกันมันก็จะเหมือนของไทยไงถ้าตัวแรกเป็น x ตัวถัดไปเป็นอะไรจำนวนคี่สองจำนวนที่อยู่ติดกันจากหนึ่งไปเป็นอะไร 3จาก1ไป3บวกเพิ่มไปเท่าไหร่2หรือจาก5ไป7เพิ่มไปเท่าไหร่คะ2เหมือนกันเพราะฉะนั้นถ้าตัวแรกเป็น x ตัวที่น้อยสุดเป็น x ตัวมากถัดมาก็จะเป็นเท่าไหร่ x บวก2เขาบอกว่ากำลัง2ของแต่ละจำนวนนักเรียน the sum of their square is นั่นนะคะ กำลัง2ของแต่ละจำนวนเท่ากับเท่าไหร่130ก็เนี่ยค่ะที่เหลือก็เป็นอะไรเป็นการแก้สมการไปปกติได้เลยใช้วิธีการแยกตัวประกอบถ้านักเรียนไม่ได้โจทย์นักเรียนก็ใช้วิธีการใช้โทรศัพท์นี่แหละค่ะส่องโจทย์แล้วก็แปลเนาะช่วยประหยัดเรามีเทคโนโลยีใช้ให้เกิดประโยชน์พยายามสังเกตคำด้วยเราเรียนเป็นภาษาอังกฤษด้วยใช่ไหมเราก็ต้องดูด้วยไอ้คำไหนมันแปลว่าอะไรในคณิตศาสตร์เนี่ยนะคะฝึกบ่อยๆ odd number กับ even number นี่ต้องรู้แล้วจำนวนคู่จำนวนคี่นะคะ
Alright, so just remember, for this case, sum of their squares is 130. So to double check the answer, 7 squared plus 9 squared. So that's why our answer is correct. That is add numbers. We already get the add numbers. Remember, in applying quadratic equation in real life situation, we don't use a negative. Okay? We don't use a negative. Finish? Easy, right? Easy.
You already answered. That's a staple. It's okay. You already.
All right, let's proceed to another example in geometric problem. So in geometric problem, for example, we need to solve the area and perimeter of the rectangle or different shape, right? Remember, perimeter and area of different shapes. So this time, we apply it into quadratic equation. So the problem in this case is find the length and the width of the rectangle filled. So the missing is length and the width. All right? Now, let us proceed in develop a solution. What are the equation that we need to use in solving this problem? So develop the solution. Let the length of the rectangle as x. Okay? And the next one is, width is, we can use 25 minus x. Okay? Because the given is already, the perimeter is 50 meter. Okay? Now, we need to develop the we need to evaluate this one. To evaluate, what is the formula for area? The formula for area is, length times width. Remember? The rectangle. The formula for rectangle is length times width. So, in this case, if the length is x, we multiply x multiply to 25 minus x. And then the area is 150. Okay? Now, proceed to multiplication. So 25x and then minus x squared is equal to 150. In this case, we have negative x squared. So we need to process it into standard form. So to process it, we need to divide both sides by negative. Okay? By negative. So we have negative times negative, x squared is positive x squared. And then negative, negative 25, x is equal to negative 150. Okay? We need to multiply both sides by negative to get the standard form for positive. So, now, proceed to standard form. So, x squared minus 25x. And then, negative, it will become positive 150 is equal to 0. Now, what is the factor for this one? The factor of 150, what is the factor of 150? If we add, the result is negative 25. What is the two number? The two number is negative 10 and negative 15. That is the factor of 150. 10 times 15, 150. So, in this case, so the answer is we have two positive, right? So, x is equal to 10. And the other one is x is equal to 15. So, to identify what is length and width, remember, in rectangle, right, the longest is length. So, we have 15 and 10. So, the length is 15 and the width is 10. If we double check the answer, area, so, we have 15 times 10 is equal to 150 meters squared also. So, our answer is correct. Okay? Are you still there? So, in getting the geometric problem, so the answer is length is 15 and the width is 10. Okay? All right, copy, 2 minutes. So remember, we just follow the, evaluate the equation area, length times width. So that's why our operation here is length multiplication. Okay? And we create a rectangle. Remember, the longest side is length, right? And the smallest side is width. So that's why if we analyze the answers, so the longest side is 15 and the smallest side is 10, which is our width. Very easy, right? Okay, that is for last example. And next is you have a worksheet. Done? Finish? All right, try this. Joke. This is not. 1 and 2. 1 and 2 only. 1 and 2. So same as in the first example and the second example. You need to find, the first one is you need to find the 2 consecutive positive even number. And the next is find the length and width of the rectangle, which is the given is area. And the length of a rectangle is 2 inches longer than. Okay? 1 and 2 only. Copy and answer. Notebook, please. Notebook. And for your homework, pass it now. Homework.
I maybe change it. Okay, so you're done.
Done?
Right?
Ah. Copy and answer. Homework, pass your homework. Homework. Just one and two. One and two only. Copy and answer one and two. Copy and answer. Same, same. You can do it in your... You can also do it on your worksheet. Worksheet, yeah. Same, same. 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 Number two question is same. I just add 2 inches longer. Same, same. Same, same. One and two, same. Do it now. One and two only. Same, same. Same, same. One and two, answer it now. Yeah, that's right. Ah, okay. X squared x plus squared. Problem solving is same as this one. Same. 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 Done. Same, same. Same, same. I just add, but same. 20 and additional 2 inches long. So you have 3 idea. Same. Hmm. But this one, you can use. Finish. Let's answer. All right, let's answer. Number one. So in number one, let X for the smaller number. And then for the next number is X plus 2. Okay? So in this case, we need to get the even, positive even number. So the equation is x squared plus x plus 2 is equal to 164. Alright? Same. Now, we need to get the product. So we have x squared plus x squared and then 4x plus 4 the constant and then 164. So this one will be minus 4. So add 2x squared plus 4x and then 164 minus 4, we have 160. And transpose, we have 160 is equal to 0. Okay? Next. Next is, we need to get the common factor, which is 2. So, 2x squared plus 2x minus 80 and then is equal to 0. And what is the factor? The factor is positive 10 and, negative 8. So, the answer for two numbers is x is equal to negative 10 and x is equal to positive 8. But we can't use a negative sign. So, the first x is 8. So, for the next number, we use x plus 2. So, the value of x is 8 plus 2 is equal to 10. So, the next is positive 10. All right. So the answer is 8 and 10. To double check, 8 squared plus 10 squared is equal to 164. So 64 plus 100. 164 is equal to 164. So the answer is correct. Okay? Do you understand? All right, next. Number 2. So in number 2, anyone who can answer number 2? You have an answer? Number 2. Okay, so for number 2, so again, the area is length times width. So let x for the width. And then for the length is x plus 2. So in this case, we multiply because the area is length times width. Yes. So we need to multiply x and then x plus 2. Okay? Is equal to 24. So in this case, we have x squared plus 2x and then negative 24 is equal to 0. Okay? And then, the factor is we have plus 6 and negative 4. So, the answer is negative 6 and positive 4. But we can also use a positive 4. So, in the second one, 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. So, the answer is 6. So, the length is 6 and the width is 4. Okay? Do you understand? All right. Okay, so that's it for today. And goodbye, class. Hello. Your worksheet, please, until 3 p.m. at my faculty or at my office. Collect, two of you collect the papers.